Senator Whitmire, did you wish to speak on second reading, I'm told? This, we're on second reading, now would be the time.
Thank you, Mr. President. Members, I rise to oppose Senate Bill 14 to second reading. And I do so basically because I think there are certain decisions you leave to the family. And this certainly is one of those subjects. Recall last session, I read letters from family, parents of transgender children. I've kept up with them. They were in the office the other day. They're doing fine. I felt like 2 years ago, as I do today, someone needs to be their voice on the Senate floor. I respect Senator Campbell, certainly representing her point of view. What concerns me is, what if you're wrong? And I hope everyone on the floor will pause for a moment and think about, what if the majority of the votes get it wrong today? Could actually be life and death matters. And I'm just shocked quite often, as I am today, that some individuals, I've been guilty of it, that just think we're absolutely right. Because generally in my world, things are gray. Not black and white, right or wrong, but gray. And it just concerns me, as we take up such a serious matter, that there's people representing their point of view, their constituents, and they just think they're absolutely right. Very seldom do I stand before you and believe I'm absolutely right. This is one of those situations. I've been here 50 years. This subject was never debated by the legislature until last session. I just wonder when it became such a serious matter. I do notice it's become a national issue as it works its way through this legislative body. And I would pray that it's not just politics, but it's genuine concerns for the health and welfare of the transgender children. And as I'm opposed to it, I could work up a sweat. I could get really energized as I was probably 2 years ago. I feel just as strongly. And I would talk till I passed out if I thought I could kill this piece of legislation, because I do believe it belongs in the hands of the family and their medical advisors. I come from Houston, the best medical center in the world. The experts disagree. I think it is still being handled by modern medicine, modern science. So as we go forward, let's be respectful of the transgender families, which has been demonstrated today. They are God's creations. And I have colleagues on the floor that believe strongly that everything in life is controlled by God, this very debate. So let's remember that the transgender children are God's creations, and we love them. We strongly disagree on what's in their best interest. That's the reason I leave it to their parents. And I just hope as we go forward that we'll be open, we'll meet with the experts, the family. I'm not sure a hearing where you can testify for 2 minutes really allows the families to describe their life experiences and their family. I met with the family last week in my Senate office. They thanked me for my concerns. They're doing fine, and I plan to remain in contact with them. And I hope Senator Campbell and all 31 of us will do everything we can to learn more and more about this subject. Lord knows, 10 years ago, I was not as familiar with it. 5 years, I was not as informed as I believe I am today. And it's really a situation where I learned how much I don't know. But I'm not different. The experts will tell you that. So I'm opposed to moving it forward. I do know from being in the Senate 40 years, very seldom are votes changed by speaking to the body. When you're a House member, you can sometime, with a good speech on the merits or lack of, you might change 30 votes in the House. And in our members that have come from the House recently, I believe will confirm that. But in this body, you're deliberative, you've thought about the subject, and I'm just speaking my part today on behalf of the families that have asked me to speak. Most of them are not constituents, and it really doesn't matter whether they live in my district or not. I'm representing a point of view of concern from families across Texas. In fact, one very prominent family that I respect their privacy have told me they will move out of state to see that their grandchild still receives the care that they're receiving. I hope this does not become an issue where if you have the means, you can go out of state and continue your treatment. And if you're lacking those means, you have to live with the challenges of that transgender child. Thank you, Mr. President and members.